Hello, this is Scott Milliken, the lead developer for openDCIM, and today I'm going to ramble about a new feature that will be available in version 4.3, thanks to an anonymous user of openDCIM sponsoring this specific development. That new feature is something that users have been asking for quite a while, which is a bulk import function from an Excel spreadsheet. Actually, there are three basic bulk import operations. We have got import new devices, import network connections, and process bulk moves and deletions. All of those come from a spreadsheet, which I've already got built. So let's take a look at that spreadsheet to start off with. Okay. So here we've got several columns in the spreadsheet. They can be in any order that you wish, but if you want to reduce the amount of clicking that you have to do, I would suggest that you put them in the order. Don't worry about what's listed here. I'll show you where you can actually get that order from. Data center has to be a unique name that you have given to a data center. I can't think of a reason why you would need to have multiple data centers with the same name. Doesn't mean that somebody else didn't have a valid reason. But in terms of the openDCIM software, if you want to use the bulk function, you have to have a unique identifier for the data center. The cabinet typically is Cartesian coordinates, XY grid coordinates for which floor tile in your data center. So it would be very common to have the same XY grid coordinate or the same letter number combination coordinate in multiple data centers. So the uniqueness that's required is data center plus the cabinet. So you can have an AB04 in 10 different data centers or 100 different data centers, but the combination of data center plus cabinet has to be unique. And that is what is in the location field of a cabinet. Position, label, and height are required fields, but there is no validation that's done on them. As you can see, you can also have zero for both the position and the height. That's because we do allow for zero U devices, things like sensors, etc., or things that may fit into the little pockets to the side of a cabinet. Manufacturers have to exist in the database, as do the model, which this refers to the field that is called model on a device template. So the combination of manufacturer plus model is how we know which device template to apply to the device that you're installing. The reason why we need that is there are a lot of extra pieces of information that it would be kind of silly to have you put into the spreadsheet every time go along with the particular device. For instance, number of power supplies, the weight, how many watts it pulls, how many ports there are, what the port names are, if it happens to be a switch, whether it's managed, things like that, or if it's a power strip, etc. Everything to the right of the model column is optional. However, if you put a value into the owner or contact field, it must exist within the database already. So the owner refers to a department name. The contact would refer to a person in the format of last name, comma, first name. So make sure that those exist, otherwise you will get validation errors. You don't have to worry about matching uppercase, lowercase. All the searches that we do in the database are case insensitive. Also, this final column, you can specify any number of tags that you wish. Tags are basically word combinations separated by a comma. So that means a comma is not a valid character within a tag. So anyway, that's pretty much the format of the spreadsheet. So let's close that out. And you will see that we have a data center here called DC1. That's what I've got in the spreadsheet, right? So DC1. And I'm putting everything into AB04, which, as you can see, is a completely empty cabinet. So let's go into the bulk importer and choose Import New Devices and pull up our bulk upload spreadsheet. And you'll see that we have a listing of the fields that I was just talking about. And if you forget what the fields really are for, just hover your mouse over for a second, and it'll give you a little bit of help text about it. If there are certain ones that you simply don't want to get mapped, such as maybe asset tag, you can choose none instead of choosing a column name. These column names are coming from the very first line or the first row of that spreadsheet. So always make sure that you start the actual data on row 2 of your spreadsheets for import, because we are using row 1 as the column names. Now, I happen to have an error in here because I'm wanting to illustrate this for you, but you click validate and it will tell you if you have any errors. This particular one is I am missing one manufacturer name and I am missing a template that is of that same manufacturer name. So let's go check and see if those happen to be in the global online repository. I happen to know they are. So let's come over here to the repository sync and let's sync up our manufacturers, because it said I needed to add the manufacturer Arista. So let's look for it in the list here. Here it is, Arista. So let's just pull that from the master, and we now have Arista as a valid manufacturer name, and we need to get the template for the 7010T-48. So we'll come down here and choose Arista, and it tells us what templates are available on the repository, and the very first one is the 7010T-48. So let's pull that down, and now we can go back to our bulk importer and we can try to import those devices. Upload it. All of our fields are mapped because I put my spreadsheet in the right order. It says everything is passed the validation, so if I hit process, it will actually add those devices. And here they are. Let's go take a look and see if they're there. Okay, look, I've actually got 27 uses of space used in AB04. And sure enough, I've got a bunch of DL380 Gen 9s, and I've got an Arista 7010T48 switch, and it's mounted in the back. Now, as you can see, there are no currently assigned network connections. So, and that was pretty helpful, being able to pull a bunch of servers in, but, you know, a lot of that work is oftentimes the network connections. Well, we've got that option as well. So let's take a look at our spreadsheet, see what format we need to be in for that. Okay, here we've got four main columns that are required. We have a source device, we have a source port, we have a host, a target device, and we have a target port. Now, it doesn't matter what you name these columns. These columns could be called Mo, Larry, and Curly for all that matters. If you can keep track of which one is which, then you can name it as however you wish. You just need to be able to keep track of what is what refers to the fields that we're looking for. Then after those four, we have got a media type, we have got color codes, and we've got notes that can be added in. So, for instance, if we wanted to, you know, add a note of management VLAN to that particular one, then we can add in a note to that particular switch, or to that particular connection. And you can change it to however you want to, you know, whatever notes you wish. Notes are completely optional. Don't have to map them at all if you don't want to. So let's save that, and let's go take a look at the bulk importer function. So, oops, not new devices, I want network connections. So we pull up the spreadsheet, do an upload, and it says, okay, here are the column names that I found. Tell me, what is your source device ID? Well, I named it source host name. And then I've got a source port, which is the port. Now, that port has to match the name of an existing port for that device in openDCIM. So if your templates do not automatically create the ports for your devices and give them specific names, then you need to change that, or you're going to have to manually add all your ports before you can make the connections. If you do it the way that, if you take a look at how I did it, it automatically created all those ports and such. Target identifier, again, we're using host name, port. I've got a media type, color code, and then notes. Now, this key field, there was not a column in the spreadsheet for key field. That's because key field is how we are going to tell OpenDCIM's import function what field within the database to search to uniquely identify each one of these devices. Now, I could have used label as the unique identifier, or I could use host name, or I could use asset tag, or I could use serial number. So any four of those can be used to specify what your source device and your target device are. In this case, I used host name. So I'm going to click host name, and then let's process that. Everything says it's successful. So let's come in here to our switch, and let's see what we've got. Okay, it says we've got, look at that, test one. And it even added that note that I put in there, management VLAN. Okay, and then here are the other connections that we had defined. It also picked the media type. Now these had to already exist in openDCIM, as I stated, and the color code in order for it to match up. Now, if you specify color codes and media types in the spreadsheet, but they don't exist in openDCIM, it will simply not set those values. So it won't error out, but it will not set those values for you. All right. So that's adding network, adding new devices, and that's adding connections. What about moving things around and deleting things? Let's take a look at our next spreadsheet. This is the simplest spreadsheet of all. We have a device identifier, which again, I'm going to go by host name. And then I have a data center. This is where I'm going to move the device to, not where it exists now, because this unique identifier will tell me where it is now. So I've specified that it is going to go to data center 1, cabinet AB05, position 1. And I can select a move date. Now, anytime that there is a date field in the spreadsheets, there was one for the new devices and there's one for the move devices. You can use any valid date format. Of course, Excel is going to automatically format it based upon what your locale is. But if you specify nothing at all, it will use the current date when you run the import process as the move date, if it is a move operation, or the current date for the install date if it is a new operation. If you do not specify a data center on one of the rows, it will look at that and say this is a delete operation. So what I am telling this is that I want to move these three devices, test 1, 2, and 3, to cabinet AB05. And I want to delete devices test 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so let's close out our spreadsheet. Let's come look at our cabinet again just so you can get a look at it. So as you can see, after we run the operation, these three devices at the bottom should be in cabinet AB05. And then the next three positions up through 12 should be deleted altogether. And as you can see, there is nothing in AB05 currently. So let's come over here to the bulk move portion. Open our file, test move and delete, upload it. Here we've got our column names that we're matching up again. And we have to specify what the key field type is. Again, I'm using host name. That is what my unique identifier is. Now, coincidentally, the host name and the label were the same for the servers, but you have to figure out which one is going to be the unique identifier. So let's validate it. It says okay, everything's good. So when it validates, it's just checking all of those move operations, because the deletes, there's nothing to really validate other than the fact that the device you're trying to delete existed. But it does do the check to make sure that you're moving it to a valid location. Let's hit process, and it says it successfully processed the move of test 1, 2, and 3 to cabinets AB05, and then it deleted 4, 5, and 6. So let's take a look. AB05 now has test 1, 2, and 3 at the bottom of it. And AB04 is missing everything below position 13. So that's pretty much it. Those functions will be available with the release of version 4.3, and I anticipate that release to come out by May the 15th, and maybe a little bit sooner. Anyway, hope this has been useful. If you have any questions or problems with this, do not leave comments on the YouTube comment section. Join the mailing list. Go to openDCIM.org, click on the participation tab, and scroll to the bottom and join the mailing list. You can also check wiki.openDCIM.org. There is actually a documentation page for the bulk operations up there already. They basically give you less information than this video does, but it's there in writing in case that will help you. Hope this has been useful, and have a good day. Thanks.